you as a new Ableton Live user are probably quite frustrated because you've landed in this unknown, complicated landscape and all you want to do is start making music. Well, it's about to get a lot easier. This story begins with Ableton Live's piano roll. How could we possibly make good chords and melodies without knowing music theory? Well, let me show you how. All you need is one of these and one of these. And no, not even one of these. We'll save that for another video. Before we jump in, let me know what the biggest challenges you're facing with Ableton Live. And hit that subscribe button, because we'll probably cover the solution to your challenge in a future video. Without any further ado, let's make some chords. The easiest way to start creating chords is to start with a single note progression first. If you don't hear a sound when you add notes, make sure this little headphone icon is enabled. Sounds pretty generic, but we're going to build on this from here. Next, add the second row of notes. This really comes down to listening and feeling the notes. If it sounds bad, either move it up or down. Next, add the third row of notes. Again, listening carefully, seeing if this is the direction we want to go in. This is also up to your creative license. Next, add the fourth row. Your chords should be sounding a lot fuller by now. That's really nice. I like that. We can use contrary motion to make our sounds more interesting. Contrary motion is where the chords move in a different direction on the scale to the note before that. We can then shorten the MIDI clip, hit duplicate, then change it up the next four bars, making it sound a little different. Next, we're going to create a rhythm. Add another MIDI track by holding Command Shift T, then add a MIDI clip by holding Command Shift M. Next, add some notes to the piano roll. We'll stick to one note for the moment and focus on creating a groove. If you have Ableton Live 11, select both the groove and the MIDI clip with our chords to bring up this view. We can now use our chords as a template and move our groove into the relevant notes. If you don't have Ableton Live 11, don't worry. All you need to do is copy the MIDI notes from our chords and paste them in our groove track. Now we can use the chord MIDI notes as a template and move our groove into those notes. Seeing as we have this template, everything we add into it will be in the same key as our song. Let's take a listen. Click the fold button to collapse the piano roll and to see this condensed view of your chords. Next, we're going to talk about creating an alternate melody. We can use the same chords template to mix and match notes. Experiment by adjusting the tail or by moving the notes around on the timeline. This is an incredibly powerful technique as you can use this melody in a different part of the song. It's important that you change things up every few bars and don't repeat the same loop over and over again. We don't always have to have all the sounds playing all together all at once. It's important to have alternate melodies for different parts of the song. Next up, the secret weapon for creating awesome melodies in Ableton Live, the arpeggiator. Add Ableton's arpeggiator MIDI effect to the MIDI track. Choose a sound. I'm going for a mallet. Copy and paste the chord progression you created in the first step to the new MIDI track. The arp will now play the notes in sequence. There's a lot going on here, so we can solo the channel to focus in on the sound. You can choose in what order the notes are played in this window. You can choose up and down. You can then edit the groove here. In this example, I'll go for random. And you can edit the speed at which the notes are played. Super powerful. To solo multiple tracks, hold Command or Control and click the solo button. But wait, There's more. Currently, the arp is locked into this box here. We can't edit the exact MIDI notes unless we change our chords or configuration of the arp. Add a new MIDI track and sound. Select the channel input. Choose a MIDI track that has your arp for the input. Arm the channel and hit record. See the notes appear on your screen. You can now freely edit the timing of these MIDI notes that was generated by the arp. If you like this video, consider watching this one next, as it will help you further along the way in your Ableton journey. If you want to jump right into making dance music, then consider watching this one next. Whoa. Whoa.